Well, okay guys, welcome back to the beautiful Australian bush. So we're out here this weekend with my swag, and inside my swag I've only got a handful of essential items. Like, we're doing it pretty minimal for this trip. Once we get to camp, I'll give you guys a rundown of what I bought with me. But the plan for the trip is we're going to walk about 10 kilometers down this river, and there's this really awesome cave that I plan to camp in for tonight. I came across this cave about a year and a half ago when I was out here with my cousin, and ever since I've wanted to come back and camp in it. Like, it is so bloody gorgeous. We nicknamed it the Paradise Cave, so that should give you guys a bit of an indication of what it's going to be like. So, like I said, it's got about 10Ks to walk down this river, and it is such a beautiful place. Like, this is probably one of my favorite places on earth, so it feels really nice to be back out here. It's got a red-bellied black snake just over there. Let's see if we get a little bit closer. Well, there's the first snake of the trip. Man, that is just insane. What an incredible cave. So I have seen this cave before. I think last time I was here, I nicknamed it the Cathedral Cave, because when you're inside it, it just like echoes, because it's like this big cavity and it kind of like bounces off this this rock wall here as well. So such an impressive cave. But this isn't the one I want to camp in. Mine's still another, I think, 4Ks to go. But I might even come back and camp here tomorrow night. I've allowed 2 nights for this trip, so maybe I'll camp 1 night at the other, and then 1 night here. I think that'd be pretty cool. So this little stretch of the river just here, like just this 100 meters or so, is probably my favorite place on planet Earth. Like, no word of a lie. I just absolutely love this little section of this river. It is just, it's just so beautiful. Especially like now, just having like the light sort of just dapple its way through the trees and sparkle in the water. And just the way the river sort of just like snakes its way around here. You've got all the beautiful yellows and oranges in the sandstone. You've got the ferns coming out of the rock. Man, it is so beautiful. Like, I absolutely love it. Like, I really want to get a picture of this, or even a painting of this up on my wall. I love it that much. When I die, if you could scatter my ashes right here, I'd be a very happy man. Sorry for whoever's drinking downstream from the river. We're walking 10 kilometers on this river sand. It's definitely an old workout for the old chicken legs. Oh, my legs are gonna be cooked by the end of this trip. Oh, I just saw snake number 2 just slither up that way. That was just a huge wedge-tailed eagle. I wish I got that on film. I think this is it.
Bloody made it.
Welcome to Paradise Cave. There she is, Paradise Cave. Man, what a spot. I feel like there was a lot more water last time when we were here. I swear it was like, I don't know, halfway up our shins last time. I feel like some of the sand has shifted as well, but I think we should still be able to camp there. things to do just nicely. Oh, let's get this stuff off. Oh, man. Looks like an old fire pit, so yeah, I guess some people have camped here recently. I don't think that was there last time. All right, so let's run through the gear that I bought for this trip. So like I said, I try to keep things pretty simple for this trip. So start off with, we've got the haversack, which is by Swagman Outfitters. And inside here, just got a Garmin PLB. It's got like a first aid kit. Just like my keys and a spare battery. And then just a water bottle. So I do have water in this at the moment, but for the rest of the trip, I will just collect it and boil it. And then for the swag, we'll take off this strap here. So that's my tucker bag. So inside here, I've just got my food. I've just got a shemagh, which was used as like the strap. Just got a titanium fry pan. Now for the actual swag, this is by a brand called Remote Projects. That's a really nice quality canvas swag made in Australia as well, made up in Byron Bay. So inside here, we've just got a hip flask full of tawny, which is always a must. We've got a bushcraft knife. This is by R&N Blades. It's a really nice knife I got recently. I'll leave a link to this in the description below if you guys want to check it out. Inside this, this is a kangaroo tail leather pouch. And inside here, I've just got a little fishing kit, which I don't think I'm going to be able to use. I've got some fishing line and some hooks and sinkers in there, but I was expecting there might be some carp around, but the water's way too low. I have seen carp around here before, but yeah, the water's too low. I did see some carp when I first started the walk in some of the deeper pools. So depending on what I do tomorrow, I might go for a fish, but I'm not really sort of counting on using this. Like, I didn't expect the water to be this low this trip. And also inside here, I've just got a flint and steel kit. So inside that, you've got the flint, you've got the steel striker. There's also some char cloth in there as well, but I've also, I'll make some more char cloth while I'm out here as well. That's how we get the fire started. So inside here is just all my electronics. So I've got like my GoPro, spare batteries, power bank, also a head torch in there as well. That actually weighs a fair bit, eh? You'd be surprised how much all the electronics weigh. And for the swag, so this is just a very simple canvas swag. It's just like a traditional style swag, which I really like. It doesn't have any bug mesh on it. So yeah, you just got zippers that go down the side here, and that opens up. And then inside here, I've just got a really thin fleece blanket, and that's all I bought for bedding. I didn't bring like an air mattress or anything like that. I'm just going to sleep straight on the ground, and I'll just use this thin fleece blanket to keep me warm, because I didn't bring any extra clothing as well. I think it's meant to get around, I think lows of around 12 or 13 degrees tonight. We're at the tail end of summer now. It was hot yesterday, but we've had a southerly breeze kick up today, so it's a little bit cool. I think the tops today were about 22 degrees, and I think it's meant to get down to around 13 degrees tonight. So, see how we go, but I should be able to stay warm with that, and I also have a fire going as well. So yeah, that's all the gear. Like I said, pretty simple for this trip. Didn't really bring too much. Obviously, like I've got like this, my safety stuff, which I don't really sort of count. But yeah, that's pretty much all the gear that I bought for the trip. Plus the food. Yeah, anyway, let's get some firewood. Alright, so full of tinder, we'll just use the dry dead leaf bases from the spiny headed mat rush. Always be pretty cautious of snakes when you're sticking your hands in. Inside these plants. Alright, so we just got the dead leaf bases from the spiny headed mat rush. I'm just going to rough these up until you get a nice fibrous material. Alright, so inside here we've just got the flint and the steel striker and just some char cloth. Alright, so then what you want to do, you want to get the char cloth and place it on top of the flint, right on the edge there. You'll get your steel striker and you'll strike that against the flint until you get a spark that falls on top of the char cloth, and then you'll add that to your tinder bundle. There we go. Just place that in your bird's nest. All right, so I've got a breeze coming from behind me, so I'll just use that to my advantage. Thought that was gonna go up then. Don't know why that didn't. Let's try it again. Damn it. I do not know why this is not going up. It's really dry, it's really fibrous. It's like it wants to go up, it's just not. I think I've only got one piece of char cloth left after this, which means if I don't get it lit next go, I don't think I'll be having a fire. Pressure's on. All right, so I've just been scouring around trying to find the driest, fluffiest material I can find. And basically one of the spiny-headed mat rushes, it's got these like dead leaf bases here. And you guys can see it, but it's, yeah, it's pretty fibrous, so it's like pretty hairy down there. So I've kind of picked a bunch off, and I'm hoping that will take. So I'll combine this with the tinder bundle I've got back there, and hopefully this will catch a light. If it doesn't, I'm pretty screwed. Man, the pressure's on now. So I've got one bit of char cloth left. Fingers crossed. You bloody beauty. I am so stoked for that. You little ripper. I was honestly starting to get worried a bit there. Usually I can get a fire started pretty easily with the old flint steel, but I was absolutely struggling then. That's third time lucky. I really need this fire as well, eh? Need it to cook food, to boil water, to stay warm. So stoked. All right, so I need to char some more material. So in this tin, I do have some cotton that I bought from home, which I can definitely char that. But if you don't have any cotton, a natural material that you can char is punkwood. So basically punkwood is timber that's like dead timber that's starting to decay. So it loses all the moisture content and it starts to go sort of that punky, flaky sort of timber. So what I might do is I might try and break this log open a bit and try and get some of that punkwood out. Yeah, so that's punkwood right there. You get that bark off. Yeah, so that's all punkwood, so that should char. All right, so just leave that in there probably for about 10 minutes, basically until it stops smoking out that little hole, and then you know it's charred. All right, that should be done. All right, so that's the charred punkwood. I had more in the tin, but I think an ember got through the hole at the top and it caught some of it alight, but I managed to save this amount, so I'll be able to use that tomorrow to get the fire started. All right, so just got some sweet corn. Now we're just gonna chuck that in the coals. We'll leave the husk on because that will help to sort of cook it and steam it. And that way we can just peel the husk off and it'll be good to go. So just chuck that in there. I'll just bury that with some coals. Alright, let's see how this corn's cooked. Mate, that looks perfect. Char grilled as well. A little bit burnt on just that end, but apart from that, it looks bloody delicious. So let's get some salt on it. Well, dinner is served. Well, it might be a simple dinner, but I am that keen for this. Lamb cutlets, cannot beat them. How's this corn? Oh man. Wow, that is really juicy. That is really flavorsome as well. That is so sweet. Oh, that is so good. Almost forgot how good corn is. Well, dinner of champions. Might chuck the camera away for now. I'll see you guys in the morning.
Well, good morning. That was a really big sleep. I was out like a light. It's actually a pretty nice sleep, eh? Like, considering I'm not sleeping on any mattress, I'm just sleeping straight on the ground, I actually had a pretty good sleep. I dug out a little ditch where my hips are, so that way it's a bit more comfier, and had a really nice night. I couldn't really sleep on my side. I found sleeping on my side, it was sort of like the sand was pushing into my ribs, but laying on my back or on my stomach, it was actually quite nice. So, yeah. Man, my voice sounds a bit weird this morning. It's about 8 o'clock. I've had a bit of a sleep in this morning. There's been a few little birds flying around the cave as well, which has been pretty cool to watch. I think we'll probably get up and get some brekkie into us.
All right, so just got some of the dead mat rush I'm just roughing up. And then once again, like I did yesterday afternoon, I'm just gonna use some of the really fibrous material that's found at the base of the dead mat rushes. So I've just collected a bunch here and it's really nice and stringy and fibrous. So that's gonna take a light really easily. So I'll just add that to the bird's nest and we've got a fire going. All right, so inside here, we've got the charred punk wood from last night. So what we'll do for this time is we'll just hold the flint over the tin and see if we can get a spark to go into that tin. We got one little spark there. Actually, that should be enough. So you guys can see that, but there we go. Got an ember forming. So what I'll do is I'll just transfer this to the bird's nest. And let's boil that into a flame. Well, that was a bit easier than last night. So as you can see, that punk wood works really well as a charred material. So I'll show you guys a little trick to get the pot off the fire. So I've just got some paracord here. I've just tied a little stick to this. Basically, the stick is like the same width as the internal of the bottle. So basically, just drop this inside and you should be able to pull that out. Yeah, there you go. Pretty nifty little trick. I might make up some more punk charwood for tonight. Just gonna get that outer bark off. See if we'll chuck that on the fire. See, there we go. Well, actually, I saw that piece didn't char completely, but the top seems pretty good and the rest of it seems pretty good, so should still do the job. All right, so for brekkie, we're gonna have some pancakes. So it's got the pancake mix in the Ziploc bag. And we'll just add some water. We'll just zip that up and we'll just mix it all through. All right, so just cut off the little corner of the Ziploc bag. So I should be able to pour the batter easier. Oh, that is hot. Just got some strawberries. You can't have pancakes without strawberries. Last but definitely not least, some maple syrup. Now that is how you do brekkie out in the bush. Oh man, that is so good. So the plan for today is, it's about 3 kilometers to sort of the end of this main gorge section, and I haven't explored down there. So I'm pretty keen to sort of walk towards the end of it and then check that out, and then we'll backtrack. And whether we camp here tonight again, or we might push on a little bit further back towards the start and maybe camp in that cathedral cave. So that way tomorrow I don't have as big of a walk tomorrow. That's like a rough plan. That rain's really starting to come down now. Yeah, anyway, finish off brekkie, we'll pack camp up and hopefully the rain holds up by then and we can make our way down the river. All right, well, this is the furthest point I've been. This is where me and my cousin got to last time, so everything from here onwards is all new to me. Keep up around here. You guys can see that one. I could like almost catch him with my hands. All right, so there's about 4 just sitting in that little pocket down there next to the rock. They look like pretty easy pickings, so I'm actually gonna try and give it a go and see if I can catch them in my hands. Goodness, I bloody got one. Oh, you are kidding me. Man, I can't believe I caught that with my hands. Oh, wow, there's still a few right behind me. Ew! Oh. All right, well, that's dinner. Let's get him out of his misery. Sorry, buddy. Thank you for your life. I can't believe I just caught that. That is insane. Thank you, buddy. Thank you so much. Oh, man, probably should have had the GoPro on for that. They went around the corner, which I didn't really expect it to. You bloody did it. Well, like, 3 years ago, I couldn't catch a fish to save my life. And here we are, catching fish with my bare hands. I cannot believe that just happened. I really wish I had the GoPro running. It's wrapped up in my swag, so I should have just taken the extra 30 seconds to get it out, because I think that footage would have been so funny to watch, but we still got him in the end. That's all that matters. Quicksand. Oh. And I still can't believe that just happened, eh? I don't think carp are exactly the smartest fish going around if I can catch them with bare hands. But yeah, it's just hit 2 o'clock, so I'm not quite sure how much further we should push on down this river. I want to leave enough time to sort of backtrack towards maybe that cathedral cave, which I think is probably at least, I think, maybe 2 hour walk. But it does look pretty nice just down there, so I might just go for a bit more of a wander. We'll see what it's like. Whether we decide to cook the carp down here for lunch, or I might save it for dinner. See how we're going. Well, just when I think I want to stop and turn around and head back, I go around like a little corner and it just looks bloody gorgeous up there. It's so pretty, this section. And so I just don't know when to stop. Just keep walking. It's about 2:30 now, so still got a bit of time, but we'll have to probably stop within the next little half an hour to make our way back. Well, without getting all hippie on ya, this place is powerful. It's got a real spirit to it. It's just so beautiful. And like when I stop talking and stop walking, it's just so quiet. Man, what a place. I would love to know the Dreamtime story for this river. And that would be pretty special. But honestly, I just imagine the old mobs walking down this river, just hunting and fishing. Or actually, maybe not fishing, because the carp up here is an introduced species. So I don't know if there was any fish up here, but definitely plenty of wildlife around here and lots of caves to live in. Definitely been a pretty nice place to call home. A little camping overhang here. Pretty nice spot. It looks like someone's camped here before. There's remnants of an old fire pit though. This area doesn't look like it's been used anytime recently, so that must be a pretty old fire pit. Yeah, really beautiful spot. I don't know how good it's gonna be leaving that carp out for a few hours before I cook it, but I don't really wanna cook it right now. It's, what's the time? So it's 3 o'clock. I might just have a quick lunch here. We're pretty much at the end of the section I wanted to check out. Like, it still looks like it's bloody gorgeous down that way. I could keep honestly going, but I really gotta know when to call it and start making my way back, so that way tomorrow I don't have a massive slog ahead of me. Yeah, what a spot to have lunch at as well. That is bloody gorgeous. Around every corner here is just better and better. Lunch today, we're just having the old barbell biltong, which once again, if you guys want to get your hands on some of this, I've got a discount code in the description below. And just a little muesli bar as well. And 3 days like isn't enough here. I feel like this is one place I could come here and spend like a week just exploring it. Like I said, like up the sort of side creeks, there'd be so many cool little caves to check out. I think it'll be about 2.5 hour hike back to the spot where I want to camp tonight. Delete this, we'll get a move on. Alright, so I've just fallen into some quicksand. My leg is like well and truly stuck. Let's get this off. Oh. Oh man, she's deep. Oh. Oh. She's really stuck in there. Oh, come on. Oh man. Come on. Oh, come on, come on. Oh, almost. Oh yeah. We're out. I think that was probably the deepest I've ever fallen in. That was like up to here. And on we go. There's so many of these little side creeks that just look so interesting. I'll have to come back one day and like really explore just the side creeks alone, because I reckon there's probably some really cool caves up there and probably some caves with Aboriginal art as well, so we'll save that for next time. There's a sly bird just singing its little head off. That is so cool. That was really cool. There's two lyrebirds up there. They obviously got their nest in one of the caves up there. I don't think they were too keen to see me, because before I came around the corner, they were just like, yeah, singing their little heads off. And as soon as they saw me, they started to make like a different kind of alarm sound. Such a cool bird. Alright, so it's just hit 5 o'clock and we've still got about a 30 or 45 minute walk to get to that cathedral cave. And then once you get there, it only gives us around about like just over an hour till it gets dark. So what I think I might do is I might actually scrap that plan. And there is a cave just here which is a really good camping cave. I camped here with my cousin last time I was here, and it's a really great cave. And there's also plenty of firewood around here, because the other issue with the cathedral cave is because it's in a narrow gorge, I don't think there's that many trees around there. So finding firewood might be a bit of a mission, and as we're starting to run out of light, it might just not be the wisest idea, because you still got to boil up water and cook up the fish and stuff as well. So at least if you camp here, it gives us at least like 2 hours until it gets dark and plenty of time to do all those chores. So also it's just started to rain as well, so I don't know if it's going to get heavier or not, but I think we might play it safe and head go up to that cave. Oh, there we go. There we go. All right, so I've got some coals built up. Now, with this fish, I'm just gonna chuck it right on top of the coals. Keep it nice and simple. Now, I've only ever had carp once before, and it actually wasn't too bad. In Australia, carp gets a pretty bad rap. It's referred to as the mud marlins, because it basically lives in pretty muddy waterways, and yeah, usually people say that the taste is terrible, but when I did try it last time, actually I'm pleasantly surprised. It wasn't the best, but it also wasn't the worst. So pretty keen to see how this one's gonna taste from this waterway. It would be nice to maybe put some spices on and just to jazz it up a bit, but we don't have them, so we're gonna do it pretty simple. I've just got some salt to chuck on it at the end. And yeah, pretty keen to see how it tastes. I think she's cooked on one side. Let's try and flip her. Man, I'm so thirsty. Starting to feel pretty dehydrated, but unfortunately that water is still way too hot to drink. That's a problem with boiling water, is yeah, it just takes so long for it to cool down. Like, you obviously can chuck it in the river to cool it down, but to be honest, I'm like lacking so much energy right now. Like, I can't even bother to run down there and run back up. So yeah, definitely makes you appreciate water filters after doing a trip like this. I wonder if the water is safe to drink just straight up. Like, it seems like a pretty clean water source, but then again, the first time I ever came to this river, I found a dead kangaroo in the river, which I pulled out, but yeah, it just goes to show you never quite know what's further upstream. All right, I reckon she's probably about done. There we go. She looks pretty cooked. Let's put a little bit of salt on it. So let's give it a taste. Just trying to get a piece without any bones in it. Here we go. There's a few little bones. That honestly tastes fine. I think I put a little bit too much salt on it, but apart from that, that actually tastes all right. I'm so surprised. Because like I said, everyone in Australia always sticks their nose up at carp, but it's actually not that bad. And that's cooked like this. Imagine if you actually put in some effort and put some spices on it. It actually wouldn't be too bad. I really think it just depends on which kind of waterway you're getting it from. If you're getting it from like a muddy dam, I reckon it's probably pretty bad, but somewhere like this, it doesn't seem too bad. That is actually pretty good. It's really juicy. It's actually like really juicy. Wow, pleasantly surprised. Once again. Well, there you go. The humble carp is actually not that bad. All right, well, I think on that note, I might wrap it up here for tonight. I'm pretty buggered and I'm pretty keen just to relax for a bit. It's been a pretty big couple of days. So yeah, I'll catch you guys in the morning. Well, she is raining. It's been raining all night. There we go. The rain's finally stopped, which I'm pretty stoked about. I didn't really want to walk out of here in the rain since we don't have any wet weather gear. But I had a pretty nice night's sleep last night. Like, I'm actually surprised how well I sleep without a mattress. The only issue is I can't sleep on my side. It just sort of like digs into my hips and stuff. I have dug like a little hip hole, but still I can't really sleep on my side, and I usually like to sleep on my side. But yeah, it's actually been a pretty nice few nights. Quite surprised. plenty of sounds last night. Lots of animals moving up and down this river. I heard something start to come up here. I'm pretty sure it was a kangaroo, but it did sort of make some weird sounds. Like, it wasn't sort of like hopping. It was kind of like thump, thump, and then nothing for ages. And then thump, thump. So it's obviously probably a kangaroo, but it was like quite loud thumps. So yeah, kind of spooked. When it started to get up like around where the ferns are down there, I quickly grabbed my head torch to try and see if I could see it, but unfortunately I couldn't. Yeah, that's one thing about camping around this area, is you tend to hear a lot of animals throughout the night.
We've got a little baby snake here. I think it's a snake. It could be a legless lizard. It's got a pretty long sort of nose on him, so I'm not quite sure. Pretty cute little guy there. However, he is right next to where I sleep in, so just goes to show that sleeping in an open swag or just inside a cave can always be a little bit risky with all these little fellas wanting to bunk up with you. I did have a few ants in there when I woke up this morning. So yeah, just one of the risks you play when you want to camp in a place like this.
Well, this has been a really fun challenge. Came out here with minimal gear, caught a fish with my bare hands, and explored one of the most beautiful places I've ever been. Now, this is what it's all about. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this one. Really appreciate all you guys watching. If you're new to the channel, feel free to hit that subscribe button and help me crack that 200,000. And yeah, I'll catch you guys on the next one. Hooroo.